Laytonsville District Volunteer Fire Department. We look back at 50 years of service to the Laytonsville community.
In the 1800s, merchants on their way to Baltimore traveled through Laytonsville, which was also known at that time as Cracklin' Town. It was given the name Cracklin' Town because of the famous cracklin' bread that was made and sold here to travelers. John Layton was the first postmaster of the town, and he named the post office Laytonsville, after his family's name, in 1850. They owned the brick house at the corner of Route 108 and Brink Road, where it still stands today. He built a saddle shop across the road, which also served as a post office for the town. The town continued under two names, Cracklin' Town and Laytonsville, for some time until the town was incorporated in 1892 under the current name of Laytonsville. Soil around Laytonsville was considered prime for planting crops with its ability to hold moisture in the driest of times. The early 1900s brought many farms to the area. Laytonsville was, and is still today, a small community nestled in the northeastern part of Montgomery County, Maryland. At that time, the town lacked a structured fire service and relied upon the citizens of the community coming together to a neighbor's aid. It wasn't long before the growing communities nearby had established their own fire department, and the town of Laytonsville would rely upon their services in the event of a fire. It was in the early 1950s, after several structures had burned to the ground, that the town realized it would need a fire department of its own. A group of town residents, now known as our charter members, held meetings in their homes to try and put a structured fire department together. The Laytonsville District Volunteer Fire Department Incorporated was chartered by the state of Maryland on June 17, 1952, with 99 charter members. A small group of members donated a total amount of $100, which paid for a 1930 Brockway pumper that was purchased from the Hightstown Volunteer Fire Department. In January of 1954, the first bylaws were adopted and officers were elected. In May of 1954, the Ladies' Auxiliary was organized. 1 month later, the Woodman Hall at the corner of Howard Avenue and Route 108 in the town of Laytonsville was donated by the Woodman and renovated for use as a firehouse. Brick was added to the exterior of the structure. After making the downstairs of the old Woodman Hall capable of housing fire trucks and the upstairs to hold functions and meetings, the Laytonsville District Volunteer Fire Department's building was completed. These quarters were dedicated on July the 17th, 1953. Laytonsville District Volunteer Fire Department was officially in service on January the 24th, 1954. The president was Al Perry, and Spencer Brown Sr. was the first fire chief. A tanker truck was donated by the G.D. Armstrong Fuel Company to haul large amounts of water. Ambulance service was instituted a few years later by using an acquired military ambulance. A new ambulance was purchased in 1959. A brush unit was purchased for woods and field fires. At that time, citizens in need of the fire department would call the Emergency Communication Center located in Rockville. The dispatcher would then call the firehouse on the phone line. This phone call would then set off the local siren that could be heard for miles around. Members, upon hearing this, would go to the firehouse. Once a crew had arrived, the truck would respond to the emergency. The Laytonsville District Volunteer Fire Department was growing in its membership and had already ordered a new pumper when all came to a sudden stop around noon on February the 4th, 1965. Charter member Nelson Whipp was across the street and could barely speak as he reported that the Laytonsville's firehouse was on fire.
What, the Laytonsville? Yeah, I thought
Firehouse. Is that engine 42? Okay, 42, 11, 54. No instructions as yet. As far as we know, the apparatus 17 is still in quarters.
Engine 8-1, can you give me a report? Mobile is fully involved. All the equipment is throwing at us. We're trying to get what we can out.
Third alarm. Company 3, 21, and truck 5 are responding. 1208 on the Laytonsville firehouse.
Fire spread quickly throughout the old wood frame structure. Although there was some speculation of a faulty furnace or perhaps bad wiring, the cause of the fire had never been determined. Those who were able came to the firehouse to try to help in any way they could. Chief Windham had entered the burning firehouse in an attempt to get the equipment out. He had to be physically pulled out of the burning structure. Francis Barber had burns to his hands after he made several attempts, but was driven back by the intense heat. With the exception of a new pumper, which was on order, and the 1930 Brockway pumper, which was kept in a separate garage, all of Laytonsville's fire apparatus was lost. Charter member Charlie Johnson remembers that day well.
My wife called me and said, the firehouse is on fire. I couldn't believe it. I came out of that house, I looked at Laytonsville, and I see black smoke rolling. I got to Laytonsville. Well, as I came out to 108, Sandy Springs' first truck was coming up. I followed that right into the firehouse, but I couldn't get to it. Parked at the schoolhouse and walked the rest of the way. I had my fire gear because that's the only reason it didn't burn up, because I had it in my truck and I bought it originally to start with. And I got that out, fires were fully involved, all of them. Master's Fire Department was there, Sandy Spring was there, Healdsburg was there, and all around. And then to come to find out, the only fire we had in town was frozen. We couldn't get any water out of it. We were there all day until about 3 o'clock in the morning, and the firehouse was burnt to the ground, just about. Well, they reorganized that night, had a big meeting with the Lions Club and a few other people. We started back to the rehabilitating.
The way that the community and all of the surrounding fire jurisdictions helped us to get back into service and cooperated so well in the near onset of this happening that we became a real strong organization.
With borrowed equipment from the Gaithersburg Washington Grove and Sandy Spring Volunteer Fire Departments, the Laytonsville District Volunteer Fire Department was back in business later that night. The task at hand was to rebuild the fire station. With donated land, the rebuilding of the Laytonsville District Volunteer Fire Department was underway. Pat Richards chaired the fundraising committee. Meeting after meeting, it was decided that the new firehouse would have two double bays, a meeting room, a kitchen, a watch desk area, and a hose tower. It would be 7,000 square feet at a cost of $83,000. Charlie Johnson and James Snyder placed the last block in place in front of the firehouse with the date 1965 inscribed on it. A ceremony marked the official opening of the Laytonsville District Volunteer Fire Department, which was attended by state and county dignitaries, as well as citizens from the town, on March 13, 1966. The economy now changed the way people lived their lives. Emergency calls increased every year, and gone were the days of working in the nearby farm fields or the local business up the street. Answering emergency calls became difficult during the work week. Both men and women found themselves working at jobs further away from home. Without losing focus as to the Laytonsville District Volunteer Fire Department's main objective, the membership knew these calls would still need to be answered. With salary money from the county government, it was decided that the Laytonsville Fire Station would hire paid firefighters to assist in answering these calls. the first career person started working at Station 17 on January the 1st, 1975. Currently, 17 career firefighters work on various shifts at the Laytonsville Firehouse. With the 70s came many changes to the fire service. With rural water supply in mind, Laytonsville led the way with the purchase of apparatus designed for larger pumping capabilities and water carrying capacities. A tandem axle Chevy Bison was purchased in 1978 for use as an engine tanker. It carried 2,100 gallons of water. Minnie, the 1930 Brockway pumper, was the Laytonsville District Volunteer Fire Department's first pumper. Minnie has long since retired for duty. Minnie is still used for parades and rides are given to children at the annual open house. James Snyder and David Music have spent many hours keeping Minnie running mechanically and making sure she shines for every occasion. Buddy Sutton now has this task today. Minnie was dedicated at the 1972 annual banquet. Fire department tasks are sometimes put to fun in competition. The members of the Laytonsville Fire Department would often find themselves at one end of a rope during a tug-of-war competition or hooking up a series of hoses at the highly competitive hookup contest against other departments. Not to be outdone, the members of the Laytonsville hookup team still today holds the county record of 12 seconds time for the hookup competition. Although we said goodbye to the 70s, we also made way for the 1980s. With a wealth of knowledge gained. A hydraulic hearse rescue tool was added to engine 172 in time to see the heavily tree-lined Route 108 become the scene of many tragic vehicle accidents. Route 108 was nicknamed Killer Highway. The National Transportation Safety Board had listed Route 108 as one of the top 10 deadliest stretches of roadways in the nation. A small box type truck was added to the fleet to take the load off of carrying rescue tools on engine 172. This vehicle was known as Special Unit 17 and was placed in service in 1983. After this unit was placed in service, the time of extracting trapped patients was cut in half. A few years later in 1986, Special Unit 17 was replaced by a much larger truck known as Rescue Squad 17. An addition was added to the firehouse, making way for more offices and an apparatus maintenance bed. An office service manager was hired to help out with the day-to-day administrative tasks. Big developers soon moved into the area, which gave the opportunity for live house burning drills. Fundraising has always been an important part of the history of the Laytonsville District Volunteer Fire Department. It was through fundraising chairman Pat Richards and many people like him who were instrumental that this firehouse even got started. Enough cannot be said for the Ladies Auxiliary of the Laytonsville District Volunteer Fire Department. They are an organization that was started to help defer the operating cost of purchasing equipment for the department. They often conduct fundraising events such as spaghetti dinners and bake tables throughout the year with a donation check given to the general membership at the annual banquet. They also respond to the scene of major incidents with food and drinks. The marching unit and tug-of-war team of the Laytonsville Ladies Auxiliary has also received many trophies from local parades and events right up to the state competitions. In 2003, the Ladies Auxiliary of the Laytonsville District Volunteer Fire Department lost its last living charter member, Margaret Johnson. She will be dearly missed, as well as all of the members of the Ladies Auxiliary past. They have played such an important role as to where the Laytonsville District Volunteer Fire Department is today and have laid the path for the future. Fundraising was also made fun with a friendly baseball game. Tickets were sold to the public to watch the members of the Laytonsville and Damascus Volunteer Fire Departments play baseball. The only difference was the players were not allowed to move anywhere unless they were on the back of a donkey. This left sore spots for weeks. Open house at Station 17 has always been a big event for the public and for the men and women of the Laytonsville District Volunteer Fire Department as well. Members demonstrate what it is they do behind the scenes. Without losing focus as to their existence, members have contests for local area school children with fire safety in mind.
Here's what Tommy got. All right. Here you go. All right.
Simulated structure fires fascinate the young and old alike. All of this puts into reality the job these members may be faced with every day. Every firefighter has a pass attached to them now as we enter into the 1990s. Technology has made its way as automatic defibrillators are now carried on fire trucks. Tanker operators can dump water with a flip of a switch from inside the cab. Thermal imagers are just around the corner as the year 2000 rolls in. In September of 2001, a group of members from the Laytonsville District Volunteer Fire Department extended their services after hijacked airplanes crashed into the World Trade Center in New York City and into the Pentagon in Virginia. Knowing that help would be needed, these members were up for the challenge of making a difference, and did so. Reflecting back on our past 50 years of service, we have seen that each and every member has in some way made an impact as to where the Laytonsville District Volunteer Fire Department is today. You are without a doubt a part of an organization that is unique by all standards and yet is thankless to so many. May you continue to be the best. Happy anniversary.
The road is long.
We
got one man in. 171 to come in.
Go ahead.
All right, this is our in the basement. We got the fire.